In the first week of May 2020, Google Algorithms new core update was released. Some webmasters are saying it as a Google core update, some are saying it as a pandemic update, and some are saying it as a forceful update. Now, what is this and whose rankings will boost up and whose rankings will fall? Let's discuss all of this. Hello friends, my name is Sumit Sharma and I am an SEO strategist. I welcome you all to this channel, Buddha's Learning. And before we dive into this topic, I request you to please subscribe this channel, press the bell icon so that you will get the latest updates on digital marketing and technology. And before this update, in the month of January and February, the two core updates are already released and we have made two separate videos on it. And their links I have put it in the I button, so you can choose those updates by visiting to those links. Now let's talk about the May core update. This update came on 4th of May 2020 and this all started with a tweet which came from the Google's official Twitter handle, Google Search Lizen.
The tweet which came on 4th of May, it was, later today we are releasing a broad core algorithm update as we do several times per year. It is called the May 2020 core update. Our guidance about such update remains as we have covered before. On the next day, another tweet from Google Search Lizen handle which came that the May 2020 core update is now rolling out live. As is typical with these updates, it will typically take about 1 to 2 weeks to fully roll out. Now, based on this particular tweet, several webmasters, they showed different response. Like Search Engine Journal, it says that a partial list of what areas are affected with this particular tweet or with this update, what are those businesses which will hamper. These will be local search businesses, health related sites, rolling out worldwide and multiple languages simultaneously. So those websites which are running their business across the world or the websites which are in different languages, they will surely hamper with this particular update. And like Tony Wright, he says that this appears to be one of the most significant update in recent memory. It's too early for anything other than analysis, but I have seen sites in multiple verticals affected. It's not clear who the winners are yet. Now for this particular rollout, we have seen mixed responses from all over the world. Like Japanese search engine marketing expert Kenichi Suzuki, he told that we are seeing a big fluctuation. The May 2020 core update seems a typical core update. Now everyone is concentrating on one point, that content is the king. If your content is unique and relevant, so your website will sure shot a winner. And if you have a thin content or a copied content, you will surely lose. Now, if we talk about another giant, that is Search Engine Land, so it says that we have received data from several search data companies and they all show that this update is big and substantial. Like Morde Obstein from Rank Ranger, he says that this May update is an absolute monster. And if we talk about SEMrush, so Yulia Ibrigomova and Olga Andrieko from SEMrush, they say that there is a very high fluctuation which can be seen, and the fluctuation score, it is touching to 9.4 on a scale of 10, as we can see here in the graph as well. And this high fluctuation is seen in mainly 5 categories: travel, real estate, health, pets and animals, and people and society. These are the 5 main categories where volatility rate or the fluctuation is touching to 9.4 or 9.5, as you can see here in this particular date, like 6th of May and then onwards. It's very high fluctuation, you can see here. And Moz is also showing the similar result. You can see big fluctuation here. Now the websites which will be benefited with this update, they will be the websites which have the health domain, like webmd.com, healthline.com, mayoclinic.org, medicalnewstoday.com, medicineplus.gov. So these are some of the websites which are gaining in terms of SEO visibility, and you can see the growth as well. There is another area which we can discuss here, and that is banking and finance sector. So the websites like investopedia.com, nerdwallet.com, bankrate.com, fool.com, thebalance.com, smartasset.com. So all of these websites you can see here, they are downgrading. So the rankings here, these are fallen drastically. The day when this tweet hit all over the world, so the mixed responses started coming. So the criticism was shared by Twitter as well. And some of the tweets are like, Google, please, we are in the midst of a pandemic. Can't it wait? It was the tweet by Abby Becky. Another tweet that was from Web Trainings. Is an algorithm update so important when most of the businesses are shutting down and user searches have declined in many industries? Another tweet that is from a webmaster, Mayank Parmar, and he says, it's pandemic and I don't want Google update to crush me at this time of financial crisis. I'm scared. So rather than saying it as a May update, many of the webmasters, they are terming it on different terminologies. One is saying it as a Corona update or pandemic update, because the timing, the rollout in the midst of a pandemic inspires alternative name suggestions in connection with coronavirus. And the others, they are naming it as Force Update, because May 4th is International Star Wars Day, and the same day that Google announced the core update, May the Force or the 4th be with you, and the good ranking, of course. So that's why these two names are also associated, Corona update, pandemic update, or we are saying it as Force Update.
And this update is specifically about the content. And one question from my side, that after 4th of May, have you noticed that your website's ranking, is it dipping down or it's constant? And I'm sure on certain keywords, your website's ranking have changed significantly, and your Alexa ranking as well. If you have seen the fluctuation in the ranking of your website, it means your website will keep on falling, because now the criteria is the unique and relevant content. It's not like what was happening in the past, that copy and paste from one website, make some changes in the content and paste it as your own content. It will not be anymore. Now, this May core update will give benefit to those websites where consistency is there in the blog posting and the site is regularly updated with the content. So you will not be surprised if some of the websites which would be landing on third or the fourth page, they will start reflecting on the first page of the Google. And it may be possible that in your case, if on certain keywords your website is ranking on the first page of the Google, it might have slid to the second page or the third page. And this update will also check that your website's content is pertained to a particular niche. It should not be like that your website is completely about a tech blogger and now you start posting about the tourism or the recipe posts. So friends, that was all from my side regarding this May 2020 update. If your website is also affected with this update, then please don't panic. Just concentrate on your content. It should be unique and relevant and be consistent in delivering these posts. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then please subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon so that you will get the latest updates on digital marketing and technology. And we'll be back with another video on digital marketing. Till then, bye-bye, take care, and enjoy learning digital marketing through our videos. Thank you.